Welcome back, everyone, to another episode of CapCast. Today, we've got David Rudell on, and he's going to be discussing SIAM. David, can you go ahead and tell us a little bit about yourself and kind of what is SIAM?
Thanks very much. Yeah, my name is David Rudell. I lead Capgemini's global SIAM practice. SIAM is an amazing capability, a model for providing modern IT and shared services. And it's utilized to manage the multiple provider environments that are typical in modern IT, and to manage multiple business units that are the consumers of IT. And Capgemini has been engaged in providing SIAM services since 2006. And we've really been noted by some of the advisors and the analysts as leaders in this capability.
Fascinated. It's great to hear that Capgemini's got such high impact in the SIAM industry. What are, I guess, some sort of techniques and practices that you use?
Yeah, what we have been able to produce over the last 15 years in our SIAM capability is a series of assets that we can bring to a customer. And these include a technology platform such as ServiceNow that we enhance to make very, very SIAM friendly. And then we deploy this at our customers and then tailor it to meet their needs. We also have a very, very complete set of processes, procedures, and work instructions that really form the playbook for our customers as they deliver these integrated services to their users.
Fascinating. Thank you, David. Now, I guess we should have explained this a little early on for our listeners, but can you go ahead and give the acronym or the definition of the acronym SIAM?
Yeah, it's Service Integration and Management. And it's a technique that's been evolving, as I said, over the past 15 years or so. We really supercharge SIAM and make it a really highly effective capability. We've done this at a number of different, both public sector and private sector customers. And it's just a very, very rich way of driving up customer satisfaction when you have a complex ecosystem.
Wow. Awesome. That kind of, I guess, answers my next question here, but I'll still ask it. It is, what scenarios is SIAM kind of best used?
Yeah, no, it's a great question. So typically, when you have a complex IT where you've got, you know, technology is changing, regulatory requirements are changing. And so in order to deliver this kind of capability, you really need a fundamental change in the framework. And it solves problems like low customer satisfaction. It solves problems of technical debt. And it solves problems where you've got, you know, all your suppliers are maybe achieving all their SLAs, but your customer at the end of the day still isn't happy. And it's focused on alignment across that entire ecosystem.
And kind of building on that, so what does good SIAM look like?
When you do really excellent SIAM, we're doing not just the sort of ITIL service management capabilities, we're also running the overall portfolio, the projects, the programs of a large enterprise. And we are integrating with sort of your DevOps capability, with your cloud capability, and having it all coexist in a multimodal service delivery framework with your traditional as well as your very, very modern IT, which allows our customers to sort of transform over time to very, very, very modern IT delivery.
Thank you so much, David. I think we'll go ahead and wrap it up there. I appreciate you coming on and kind of filling us in on SIAM and telling us all about it. Thank you again for coming on.
Thank you.